Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, I will bring to you the current affairs for 22nd of March. So let's start the video. Which country is making the world's first exascale supercomputer, which is called Aurora? Aurora exascale supercomputer is being built and it will be built by the year 2021. This project will be undertaken by America. The answer is USA. India and the army of which country? They did an operation called Operation Sunrise. Operation Sunrise was carried out to wipe out the insurgent camps. They were planning to hit the Indian workers who are at the Kaladan Transit Project. Kaladan Transit Project is a project which will connect Myanmar with India. So India and Myanmar army, they jointly conducted Operation Sunrise. The Reserve Bank of India has announced that any person who is traveling from India to Nepal or Bhutan, any person if he is going from India to Nepal or Bhutan, may carry up to how much? 200 and 500 rupee notes, currency total. Total amount that he can carry is 25,000 rupees in the form of 200 or 500 rupee notes. Which IT company has developed the blockchain-based global payment network, which is called WorldWire? It's a blockchain-based global payment network called WorldWire. It has been made by IBM. IBM. Also remember, World Bank recently launched the world's first bond based on blockchain technology, and it was called Bond I. And the responsibility for issuing these bonds was given to the Commonwealth Bank of Australia. And Bond I is also a name of a famous beach in Sydney, and that it is called Bondi Beach in Sydney. That is why this bond was named Bondi or Bond I. Who has been appointed as the interim president of Kazakhstan? Interim president of Kazakhstan is Mr. Kasim Zomart Tokayev. Okay, and also remember that the new capital of Kazakhstan, actually not new, they have just changed the name of the capital from Astana to Nur Sultan. Kazakhstan's capital is Astana. The new name of Astana now is Nur Sultan. Also remember, recently the country Macedonia changed its name to North Macedonia. There is a book that has been written by two people, Dr. Y.V. Reddy, who is the chairman of the 14th Finance Commission, and Dr. G.R. Reddy. Y.V. Reddy and G.R. Reddy have written a book called Indian Fiscal Federalism. It was launched by which person? It was launched by the Governor of the Reserve Bank of India, Shaktikant Das. And also remember, the chairman of the 15th Finance Commission will be N.K. Singh. Google has launched its cloud gaming platform. What is the name of it? It was launched during the Game Developers Conference in San Francisco, America. It is called, the name is Stadia. Stadia is the name of the Google cloud gaming service. The Insolvency and Bankruptcy Board of India, IBBI, they have signed a memorandum of understanding with which bank or which ministry or which organization for the effective implementation of the new bankruptcy law. They have signed it with SEBI, Securities and Exchange Board of India. The central government has approved the name change of Old Monkey Village of which state to Mungangkhung. The old name was Monkey Village. It's a village which is in a district called Tuan Sang District. T-U-E-N-S-A-N-G. Tuan Sang District, which is in Nagaland. Now it will be named to Mungangkhung. What was the rank of India in the among the happiest countries of the world 2019? India's rank is a very poor 140. And in fact, Pakistan is happier than India. Pakistan is ranked 67. The happiest country in the world is Finland. And the most unhappy country in the world, which is ranked last at 156, is South Sudan. South Sudan's capital is Juba. And Sudan's capital is Khartoum. There is a company of India called Accord Group. And the Ministry of Oil of Oman. Oman's capital is Muscat. It's a Gulf country. So India's Accord Group and Oman's Oil Ministry, they have signed a $3.85 billion deal to build an oil refinery in which country? Together, they will make an oil refinery in third country, which is Sri Lanka. Sri Lanka. Now, 70% of it will be owned by the Accord Group, and the remaining 30% by the Oman's oil ministry. Also, India did a military exercise with Sri Lanka, which was called Mitra Shakti. It was done by India and Sri Lanka. Kazakhstan's parliament, they have voted to rename the country's capital Astana to what? So Astana's new name will be Nur Sultan. Nur Sultan. Why Nur Sultan? Because the former president of Kazakhstan and a great leader and very popular, his name was Nur Sultan Nazarbayev. Nur Sultan Nazarbayev. So to honor the former president Nur Sultan Nazarbayev, they will rename Astana to Nur Sultan. Which company has launched the smart garbage bins? Okay, for smart waste management. Smart garbage bins were launched by Steel Authority of India Limited, SAIL. So the answer is SAIL. Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games. The torch, this is the official torch of the Tokyo 2020 Olympic Game. This torch is cherry blossom shaped. And which city has been chosen as the starting point for the Olympic torch relay? The city is Fukushima. Fukushima has been chosen because, you know, during the tsunami in 2001 and also in 2011 earthquake, the city was completely destroyed. Fukushima was completely destroyed in 2011 earthquake also. There was a Fukushima disaster, nuclear disaster also. So that is why Fukushima has been chosen. Also, Mirai Towa will be the official mascot for the games. Which bank is raising 250 crore by issuing Basel III compliant bond? So the deadline for Basel III is already over. It was 31st March 2019. And Basel III compliant bonds will be issued by the South Indian Bank. Can you tell me where is the headquarters of South Indian Bank? Which football club was officially declared the I-League champion? I-League champion was Chennai City Football Club. Chennai City Football Club. Also remember, there is a club called Real Kashmir. And the goalkeeper of Real Kashmir, Bilal Khan, he is the goalkeeper. Bilal Khan was awarded as the best goalkeeper of the tournament. And the top goal scorer was Pedro Manzi. Pedro Manzi and also Wills Plaza. Pedro Manzi plays for CCFC and Wills Plaza plays for Churchill Brothers. They scored 21 goals each. Fourth round of free trade agreement talks between India and which country were concluded in Lima? So you know Lima is the capital of Peru. So the answer is Peru. State Bank of India, SBI, they have signed an agreement with which bank? It is considered the third largest bank in the world by capital size to boost the business opportunities. They have signed it with Bank of China. Bank of China. Now remember, State Bank of India already has a branch in Shanghai. According to a recent study, fishing and coral reef degradation has threatened which fish species in Andaman? It is called bumphead parrotfish. It is threatened because of this. It is categorized as vulnerable according to the IUCN Red Data Book. Also recently, humpback mahasir fish was declared critically endangered. Which country's army has announced they will create a new specialized battalion that will consist of Gurkhas? Gurkhas have completed 200 years of service to Britain, and therefore Britain will create a new battalion consisting of Gurkhas. Which e-commerce company has deployed more than 100 artificial intelligence empowered robots to basically sort the customers' packages according to their location? This has been done by Flipkart. Flipkart is investing heavily in artificial intelligence. Which country will build artificial islands for amount of $79 billion by 2032. It has been announced by Hong Kong. Hong Kong is the special administrative region of China, and so is Macau. When the demand for a good increases with an increase in income, such a good is called what? If your income increases, you will want to buy it more. It is called a superior good. Who among the following was the court physician of King Kanishk? His name is Charak. He wrote a book also called Charak Samhita. And remember, Charak is also called the father of Indian medicine. And the father of Indian surgery is Susruta. Also, Charak contributed significantly to Ayurveda. Subordinate courts are supervised by which court? Subordinate courts are supervised by the high courts. High courts. So remember, just below the Supreme Court, we have the High Court. And high courts are the highest court in the states. The high courts are also part of the Indian judiciary, as you know. And high court supervises the subordinate courts. So this was the video for 22nd of March. I hope you learned and enjoyed the video. Do like, comment, share and subscribe. Give me a thumbs up. Take care. Goodbye. See you in my next video. Hello, everyone.